Good morning, Brethren of Holy Joy Church Incorporated UAE, in the Main Church of Sharjah, branches in Dubai, Abu Dhabi, Ajman, Ras Al Khaimah, members of Holy Joy Church Incorporated Doha, Qatar, all Berean pastors, ministers, pastors in training, Berean students of Malaysia and UAE, Shabbat Shalom. So today, our theme today and next this week and next week, our theme is the cities of refuge, the attachment of attachment to life. And I will be preaching about the attachment to life. So let us pray. Father God, thank you, Father, that you are always with us. I pray, Father God, that you have sent billions and legions of angels to surround us, protect us, deliver us from the evil one, angels, the destroyers, ministering angels of God, angels of the Lord assigned to Holy Joy Church, Incorporated UAE and Knowledge Branches, and Berea Academy, Middle East, and even the houses, dwelling places of members who are watching this live streaming in their homes, and also those, the all of the invitees that they have asked to also join us today, that their homes are also surrounded, protected by the angels of the Lord, legions of angels of the Lord, and the angels, the destroyer, to protect us, deliver us from the evil one. I bind, I break, I cancel, and I reject any demonic contamination from the devil and my flesh in my preaching this live streaming today. I also declare, Lord, that those we have invited, touch their hearts, Lord God, that they will receive you and they will confess that you are the Lord, the Savior, and Master of their life, so that on judgment day, they are your children, they will be able to enter the new Jerusalem, your heavenly dwelling place. In the mighty name, Yeshua HaMashiach, I pray. Amen. So, let us open our Bible and go to Luke 23, verses 35-43, the crucifixion. Verse 35, and the people stood by watching. And even the rulers were sneering at him, saying, he saved others, let him save himself, if this is the Christ of God, his chosen one. Verse 36, the soldiers also ridiculed him, coming up to flesh and spirit, offering him sour wine. Verse 37, and saying, if you are the king of the Jews, save yourself. Verse 38, now there was also an inscription above him, this is the king of the Jews. Verse 39, one of the criminals who were hung there was hurling abuse at him, saying, are you not the Christ? Save yourself and us. Verse 40, but the other responded and rebuking him said, do you not even fear God, since you are under the same sentence of condemnation? Verse 41, and we indeed are suffering justly, for we are receiving what we deserve for our crimes, but this man has done nothing wrong. Verse 42, and he was saying, Jesus, remember me when you come into your kingdom. Verse 43, and he said to him, truly I say to you, today you will be with me in paradise. Amen. So, introduction, Christians know that we have the body, the soul, and the spirit. And together, they are called life. The life of the spirit and the life of the soul. This is different from the concept the people of this world have. Since people do not know this, they only take care of their flesh. Only when they believe in Yeshua HaMashiach, that they know that once the body is destroyed, once the body is dead, there is no more opportunity. It is the end. It is the final. Amen. The Son of God opens the doors to life of the spirit and the life of the soul. He speaks to people to have attachment to life again and again. Through its attachment to the will, to life, will they seek the Lord and deserve to be saved and to return to God in the New Jerusalem. Amen. First point, life after flesh dies. In the past, when we did not believe in Yeshua HaMashiach, we only knew about our flesh. Hence, until now, we are only concerned of what the flesh eats and drinks. We never look forward to anything else. And as people live in the flesh, if they encounter hardships and are hurt, they just give up, they commit suicide. But after man came to faith in Yeshua HaMashiach, though he was not in despair because life was so difficult, he said, "Oh, I wish God would take me away quickly." Sometimes his heart becomes weak. He is tempted to think of such thoughts. Since we don't know there is afterlife, before we believe in Yeshua HaMashiach, we thought everything would end if we take our lives. However, after we believe in Yeshua HaMashiach, we realize that who human beings really are, as well as the fact that man has a spirit, body, and soul, and how we have to prepare our life after our flesh dies. 1 Thessalonians 5, chapter 23. How now may the God of peace himself sanctify your entirety, and may your spirit and soul and body be kept complete without blame at the coming of the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. Once the flesh is dead, we cannot escape the eternal curse, and we cannot die, even if we want to, and have to bear the consequences forever. So, Yeshua HaMashiach came to destroy the devil's work so that upon the completion of God's work, he could grant salvation to men as a gift. Buddhists believe in reincarnation. They believe they will be reborn after death. They look forward to the life they will be born into. They believe that although someone is very poor in this present life, he can be born again in his next life as a very happy person. So this is their hope. Amen. But the reincarnation, they believe in faith, is different from the resurrection. The resurrection, which I discussed in the past week's preaching, talks about our own self that will resurrect. We will have this mortal flesh and be transformed into an imperishable body. In other words, we will be transformed into an imperishable body. 1 Corinthians chapter 15, verse 42, So also is the resurrection of the dead. It is sown a perishable body, it is raised an imperishable body. In reincarnation, people will be born again into something else. Perhaps an insect, a dog, or an any animal there is in the planet in a cycle of 408,800 births. So, reincarnation is an endless cycle of deaths and rebirths. But for us Christians, we believe that once we die, we will face judgment because it is ordained that man dies only once. Hebrews chapter 9:27, and just as it is destined for people to die once, and after this comes judgment. Second point, flesh is in bondage to the law. Man's flesh is in bondage to the law. It is to the law. So the flesh cannot be denied because it is bondage to the law. The flesh is fettered and cannot be denied. Hence, there is no way of denying the flesh. We have to acknowledge the Lord always. Always acknowledge the Lord. We clearly know that the law has brought man's attention to the flesh. The people of Israel do not have a spiritual life, but they have physical discipline through the law. The law connected God and the Israelites' flesh. Because of the law, man cannot deny the existence of the flesh. If one grumbles because of this, it is unbelief. If one does not rely, he will fall away. Now that we are not under the law anymore, we have to come to Yeshua HaMashiach, the one who has liberated us from the law. In Yeshua HaMashiach, the sanctity of the saints replaces the function of the law. Sanctity is a kind of commandment by which people cannot deny the flesh. In other words, people have discovered the existence of the entity called the flesh through this commandment. We have to acknowledge our flesh and do not deny it. To deny the flesh means that one considers humans and animals alike as equal. In this world, a person may become rich from his labor under the sun. But when he departs from this world, he does not take anything with him. That is why King Solomon in Ecclesiastes mentions 5 times that they are just vanity, all vanity, because there is nothing gained from man's labor under the sun. Ecclesiastes 1:1-2, the words of the preacher, the son of David, king of Jerusalem. Vanity of vanities, says the preacher, vanity of vanities, all is vanity. But for us who are in God's work, before our Lord, nothing we do is in vain. Nothing is in vain. Toiling under the sun is in vain. They are the people living under the sun. But we are not living under the sun. We are in the presence of the Lord Yeshua HaMashiach. Our flesh, our spirit, and our soul are in the presence of God, not under the sun. The time we are in the flesh is the opportunity, a period of time given us to return to God. When we are in the flesh, we are in the period of preparation to prepare ourselves to return to God. When we are in the flesh, we prepare ourselves to enter the heavenly dwelling place of God. That is why if we miss this opportunity on earth while we are in the flesh to repent and to commune with God, we will certainly be thrown into the lake of fire. Kaya po, marami ang ihahagis ng lake of fire. Only very few will be able to be, will be saved. It's because we always miss. Many have missed this period of preparation. Amen. 2 Thessalonians chapter 5 verse 23. Now, may the God of peace himself sanctify you completely, and may you whole spirit, may your whole spirit, soul and body be preserved blameless at the coming of our Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. In the same manner, Yeshua HaMashiach also regarded his 30 years on earth as his time of preparation. Then he used 3 years for his public ministry. His public life is the fulfillment of everything he came to do in the flesh. He accomplished every task he had to do by coming in the flesh. When Yeshua HaMashiach, the Word incarnate, came, his flesh has a mission. And in 3 years of public ministry, he accompanied all the tasks in his flesh. Though our flesh brings anguish and sufferings, now mankind, how thankful are we that God has given us the flesh. Without our flesh, our soul will not exist. Because we have the flesh, we have the soul. Because of the flesh, we come to know our spirit and our soul. We came to acknowledge the spirit and our soul. That is why humans are far better than animals, because inside the man is the spirit and the soul. Amen? Third point, Son of God is the key. Yeshua HaMashiach is the key to freedom. When we believe in the Son of God, He automatically opens for us to love the attachment to life. God will save all who have known His Son, Yeshua HaMashiach, and believe in His name. So yan po ang requirements, that we know the Son of God, Yeshua HaMashiach, and that we believe in His holy name. Amen? After Adam fell, mankind was in darkness. All was doomed to be to the hell fire. Only when the Son of God came and liberated us from the law, that we received a strong defender, a personal refuge, and a shield from bulwark. Psalm 91 verse 2, I will say to the Lord, He is my God, and He is my refuge and my fortress, my God, in Him I will trust. The devil has locked us up with his wickedness and evil ways. But Yeshua HaMashiach came to unlock us to freedom. That's why he is the key. Psalm 91 chapter 3 to 4, surely he shall deliver you from the snare of the fowler and from the perilous pestilence. He shall cover you with his feathers, and under his wings you shall take refuge. His truth shall be your shield and bulwark. Amen. In the Old Testament, sinners have no choice but to receive the punishment of death. Murderers, though they have killed unintentionally, had to face the avengers of blood and die. But when they were just across from Jericho, before entering the promised land, God told Moses to command the children of Israel to give cities of refuge to where manslayers who have not intentionally killed someone would flee. This is the first time that God talks about the importance of the attachment to life. So, they will live and not die unnecessarily. I will discuss about these six cities of refuge lengthily in my next preaching next week. Our God is preparing the hearts of His people to receive the Son, Yeshua HaMashiach, when He comes to be their safest and personal refuge. Amen. Numbers 35:9-12. Then the Lord spoke to Moses, saying, speak to the children of Israel and say to them, when you cross the Jordan into the land of Canaan, verse 11, then you shall appoint cities to be cities of refuge for you, that the manslayer who kills any person accidentally may flee there. Verse 12, these shall be cities of refuge for you from the avenger, that the manslayer may not die until he stands before the congregation in judgment. Today, the Son of God is our refuge from the danger of curses, condemnation, and from eternity in the lake of fire. We have to rely on Yeshua HaMashiach to be able to have a complete assurance of protection and security while on earth. Amen. Fourth point, the attachment to life. What is fundamental in the faith life is to have an attachment to life. The law makes us have an attachment to life in the flesh. In the Old Testament, a person who commits sin was supposed to be stoned to death. They would kill the sinner. Since the sinner is put to death, the sinner who intends to live longer has to run to any of the six cities of villages. He just has to run. It does not matter which one of the six cities of refuge, as long as he gets inside the city of refuge and he will live. in order to survive the murderer who has killed someone unintentionally has to run from morning to evening and get into the city of refuge before the gate is closed. That's why they have to run. Because if they enter, when they reach the gate of the city of refuge and the city of refuge is already closed, then they cannot be saved. They are now subject to be killed by the avenger of death. Amen? On his way to the city of refuge, as he is running, the avenger of blood must go after him. The avenger does not necessarily be a relative or blood relation. He is the one who has seen the murderer kills the victim. So, hindi po kailangan na ang avenger of blood is a relative. Sino man sa mga Israelita na nakakita sila sa pagpatay ng isang tao, then he is now required to run after the killer so that the killer will be stoned to death. So, hahabulin niya yun. Ito namang nakapatay unintentionally, he has to run. Why? Pag nasarhan na nga yung gate, hindi siya makapasok, he is now wala ng rason na hindi siya mapatay ng avenger of death who is also following him, running after him. Amen? Hence, the man who sees the commission of the murder must go after the sinner, otherwise he will be accountable for the crime and he becomes the sinner. Amen? If he stones to death the sinner, he too will become a murderer, although he obeys God's commandment. So yun pong humabol sa kanya, kung mapatay yung killer, yung murderer, he will also become a murderer. Amen? Hence, in order not to be a murderer, you should not witness another person's crime. In other words, you should not meddle with the sin of others. Yan. May mga mahilig na sinusundan dahil usyosiro. Ayan, sa pagka-usyoso, tinignan talaga kung sino yung nakapatay. Ayan ang mangyayari. You will become a murderer when you witness the murder or the sinner does it. Amen? Cain murdered his brother Abel. But in Genesis 4:13-14, Cain said to God, "Surely you have driven me this day from the face of the ground, and I shall be hidden from your face. I shall be a fugitive and a vagrant of the earth, and shall happen that whoever finds me will kill me." God has seen that Cain still desires to live despite his sin. So God put a mark on Cain so that whoever finds him will not kill him. Genesis 4 verse 15, "So the Lord said to him, therefore, whoever kills Cain, vengeance will be taken on him 7 times as much. And the Lord placed a mark on Cain so that no one finding him would kill him." The attachment to life is the desire of the sinner to continue to live. Yan po ang tinatawag na attachment to life. So Cain was saying that though he killed his brother, but he still wants to live. Amen? Though Cain killed his own brother, but when he wanted to live, when he desired to leave, Cain begged for his life. Putting aside his conscience, then he will leave. Amen. One's attachment to life is more important than one's conscience. God will put a mark on the one who strives to save his life. Amen. God declared that whoever kills Cain or anyone who tries to save his life, he will suffer God's vengeance sevenfold. Amen. So those who will kill Cain, then they will earn the vengeance of God sevenfold. The Holy Bible has put a heavy premium on attachment to life. It says that if you see your neighbor is perishing, but you do nothing about it, you will be accountable for his blood. Though that man died of his own sins, you will be made accountable for his sins. Amen. Fifth point, grieve sin not to evangelize. We have to understand how grieve a sin not to evangelize. So yung ayaw, nahihiya na mag-evangelize, anong sabi ng ating Bible? You will be committing a sin. Evangelism is just one word, but the book entitled Principles of Evangelism of Dr. Reverend Dr. Kidong Kim, the founder of Seoul Songrak Church and Berea, is 800 pages thick. We can see how important evangelism is. This is the attachment to life. Amen. The criminal who was crucified with Yeshua Messiah begged him to save him. Lord Yeshua Messiah was there being crucified with him. He said, Lord, remember me when you're coming to your kingdom. Amen. Yeshua Messiah did not ask anything from him, but he immediately gave the criminal an assurance of forgiveness by saying, assuredly, I say unto you, this is the criminal who was crucified beside Yeshua Messiah, begged for his life by saying, Lord, remember me when you're coming to your kingdom. Yeshua Messiah did not ask anything from him, but he immediately gave the criminal an assurance of forgiveness by saying, assuredly, I say to you, you will be with me in paradise. So that was the promise, assurance of Yeshua Messiah. In Luke 23:39-41, one of the criminals who were hung there was hurting abuse at him, saying, are you not the Christ? Save yourself and us. Verse 40, but the other responded and rebuking him, God, he said, God, save me, in other words. But the other who responded rebuked the other criminal who was hurling insults to Yeshua Messiah. Verse 41, and we indeed are suffering justly, For we are receiving what we deserve for our crimes. But this man has done nothing wrong. Amen? Verse 42, and he was saying, Jesus, remember me when you come into your kingdom. Verse 43, and he said to him, truly I say to you, today you will be with me in paradise. Amen? Today, God doesn't disappoint those who have such love for attachment to life. Although you are a sinner, if you want to live, you can be saved. Today, God is telling all of us to check on ourselves. Do you desire to live despite your multitude of sins? Are you truly seeking for a one-time solution to all your troubles and problems? Then, there is only one answer. Have an attachment to life. Attach yourself to the Lord Yeshua HaMashiach. If this message today touches your heart as you are searching, may I encourage you to follow me as I pray the sinner's prayer. I am now inviting you to follow me as I pray in an audible voice. So let us pray. Father God, our Father in heaven, we are truly grateful of your love for us. The love that brings us back to you through your only begotten Son, Jesus Christ of Nazareth. I thank you that you have never given us up, but you have waited for us for a long, long time to return to you. Lord Jesus, forgive me of all my sins and help me also to forgive others. I invite you now to dwell in my heart as my Lord and Savior, Master and God of our life, in my heart as my Lord and Savior, Master and God. Write my name, Lord Jesus, in the book of life, so that on judgment day, I will be with you in your dwelling place, the new Jerusalem. Amen, amen, and amen. So conclusion, from the beginning of time, our Lord, our God, has already demonstrated to us the importance of desiring to live. By commanding the Israelites in the past to set up 6 cities of refuge, God has given us the way to go back to the Father by attaching our life to His only begotten Son, Yeshua HaMashiach. Today, there is no more cities of refuge, but the true and only refuge, Yeshua HaMashiach, has come for us. He has offered himself on the cross and has assured us of his protection until now in Yeshua HaMashiach's mighty powerful name. Amen, amen, amen. Hallelujah. Thank you, Yeshua HaMashiach. Thank you. Ruach HaKodesh Elohim. Thank you, Abba Sheba Shamayim. Amen.
Amen. Please stand by, my dear brothers and sisters, for the response song. God bless us all. Shabbat Shalom for all.